Until stimulated, the resting potential of cardiac muscle cell remains stable at approximately minus 90 mV. This resting state is known as phase 4 of action potential. Following phase 4, four additional phases characterize depolarization and repolarization of the cell. When propagated impulse comes from the pacemaker, cell membrane becomes less negative, minus 60 mV. This level of membrane potential is threshold for sodium channel activation, and phase 0, that also known as depolarization, begins. The voltage-dependent sodium channel provides the inward sodium current, responsible for the zero phase upstroke and conduction of the action potential in atrial, ventricular, and Purkinje tissue. Every action potential current is usually marked as capital I letter and the name of the ion that moves, so sodium inward current called I sodium. One of the most important parts of sodium channel is alpha subunit of channel pore, which is encoded by gen that called SCN5A. Gain of function mutation of SCN5A gen lead to long QT syndrome type 3. After sodium current depolarizes the cell to positive level of membrane potential, that is around plus 10 mV, the magnitude of sodium inward current decreases rapidly, causing the membrane potential to stop moving in a positive direction and beginning the repolarization process. A small fraction of total sodium current, however, persists during the plateau phase, that called late sodium current. We will mention this late sodium current later. Following rapid phase 0 or depolarization that puts the membrane potential into positive voltage range, a brief current of initial repolarization during phase 1 returns the membrane potential to approximately 0 mV. It is caused by short-lasting outward potassium channel activation that generates the ATO current. The channel is composed of multiple protein subunits, including an alpha subunit that forms the channel pore and is encoded by the gen KCND3. While rare genetic mutations have been described, loss of ATO current in chronic ischemia and heart failure is associated with some prolongation of the action potential duration. The next phase is phase 2, that is also known as plateau phase. This relatively long plateau phase of action potential is mediated by the balance between the inward calcium current and outward potassium current. Calcium current flows through the special L-type calcium channels. This current is marked as I calcium L. The important part of calcium channel is alpha subunit of channel pore, which is encoded by gen that called CACNA1C. Gain of function mutation in CACNA1C gen lead to long QT syndrome type A, which is also known as Timothy syndrome. Calcium entry proceeds in more gradual fashion than initial influx of sodium in zero phase, because the calcium channel activation is slower and channels remains open much longer compared to the sodium channels. Calcium ions that enter to the cell during this phase play a critical role in triggering additional internal calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which is important in initiating myocyte contraction. Outward potassium current flows in competition with the inward calcium current during the plateau phase. Outward potassium current is represented by activation of potassium slow channels. These potassium slow channels activate slowly following phase 0 depolarization and increases gradually during the action potential plateau phase. Slow channels are formed by coassembly of the channel pore forming alpha protein that called KV71, which is coded by KCNQ1 gen, and with a small protein called MinK, a small minimal potassium channel protein that is encoded by gen KCNE1. Alteration of either component due to loss of function mutation can cause long QT syndrome type 1 and type 5, respectively. Current that is generated by potassium slow channel is small and may be even absent in normal human ventricular myocardium, particularly at long cycle lengths. For example, in case of bradycardia develops, it assumes more importance as heart rate increases and or during sympathetic stimulation, both of which increase the magnitude of this current and cause acceleration of repolarization. The number of slow potassium channels varies quantitatively in different regions of the ventricle. Myocardium can be divided into three parts. The first one is part that near to epicardium. The second one is part that near to endocardium. And the last one is mid-myocardial cells, also known as M cells, that is located between the previous two parts. As a result, slow potassium channel are expressed more in epicardial and endocardial muscle than in mid-ventricular regions. The current is called IKS current, when S means slow. During phase 2, near equality of current from inward calcium and outward potassium results in nearly zero net current, and the membrane voltage does not change during the prolonged period of time, which accounts for the flat plateau portion of the action potential curve. Another important outward potassium current is ultra-rapidly activating potassium outward current with slow inactivation. The alpha pore-forming subunit of the channel is encoded by the gene KCNI5. This potassium ultra-rapid current is mostly expressed in atrial cells that change the current equality between the calcium influx and potassium efflux in the site of potassium efflux. Therefore, membrane potential becomes negative in faster fashion, and this current makes plateau phase shorter in atrial cells. As a result, total action potential duration in atrial cells are smaller. Loss of function mutations have been documented in case of familial atrial fibrillation. Now let's remain about the small fraction of the total sodium current that provided the zero phase, and which also persists during the plateau phase and called late sodium current. The protein that forms the sodium channel pore is coded by SCN5A gene. Gain of function mutation of SCN5A gene lead to long QT syndrome type 3. Primarily, the late sodium current plays important role in ventricular muscle in Purkinje fibers, provided inward current that retards repolarization. The next phase is phase 3, or repolarization, which are provided by different outward potassium currents. The first current that is responsible for termination of action potential plateau phase and initiation of action potential repolarization is rapid potassium current. Rapid potassium channel activates relatively rapidly and maintains significant outward current during the phase 3 of action potential. One of the most important proteins that forms the rapid potassium channel is HERG protein, which is encoded by KCNH2 gene. Inherited loss of function mutations in KCNH2 gene, causing a decrease in rapid potassium current, are associated with the prolongation of the action potential repolarization and congenital long QT syndrome type 2. The current marks as IKR current when R is rapid. Potassium slow outward channel are also active during the third phase of action potential. The last outward current that is involved in terminal part of repolarization, inward rectifer potassium current. This channel can work in both outward and inward direction, which is dependent on the action potential value and action potential phase. But in the terminal part of repolarization, this channel provides the outward potassium current. This potassium inward rectifer channel, briefly KIR 2.1, is encoded by the gene KC1J2. An inherited loss-of-function mutation in KCNJ2, which decreases the IK1 current, results in prolongation of action potential duration and congenital long QT syndrome type 7, which is also known as Andersen-Tawil syndrome. The another important function of the inward rectifier current is set the resting potential at -90 mV in atrial, ventricular and Purkinje cells. Phase 3 completes the action potential cycle with a return to resting phase 4, preparing the cell to the next stimulus or depolarization. There are two major exchangers which are working during the action potential, sodium-potassium pump and sodium-calcium exchanger. Let's start from sodium-potassium pump. The sodium-potassium pump moves 3 sodium ions out of the cell in exchange for 2 potassium ions that is moving into the cell. This ion movements generate the outward IP current. It should be noted that these ion movements go against concentration gradient, consequently means it requires the energy from ATP splitting. A decrease in pump current can cause prolongation of action potential duration. Also, QT interval usually does not lengthen significantly. Another important exchanger is sodium-calcium exchanger. During sodium-calcium exchanger work, 3 sodium ions are exchanged for 1 calcium ion. It uses the energy that is stored in electrochemical gradient of sodium and generates the current carried by sodium, the direction of which is dependent on the membrane potential. This current can be outward during the positive membrane potential of initial repolarization phase or phase 1, when 3 sodium ions move out from the cell, in exchange for 1 calcium ion that moves into the cell. This mode of exchanger work for sodium efflux goes on very short period of time. This current also can be inward in case the more negative membrane potential during the later depolarization. When 3 sodium ions move into the cell, in exchange for 1 calcium ion that moves out from the cell. Therefore, this is one of the ways how the cell removes the excessive amount of calcium. More of the time, sodium-calcium exchanger works in this calcium efflux direction. If you like the content, press like, subscribe to our YouTube and Telegram channel, and have a good day!